Okay, I figured I'd do a little video on this sort of, well, it says official mess kit on the front here. I had this like a long, long time. I got it at like a yard sale or something when I was a kid, and I don't know if it was like, it could be almost 30 years ago. I don't know. Something like that. I don't know. But it's, I wasn't really sure what it was. I kind of thought it was a copy of American military or something like that. But the other day I was looking around on YouTube, and there's a guy I'm subscribed to that reviews different mess kits and stuff like that, and he had a Boy Scouts of America mess kit that they had, and he had one of the, like, one of the steel ones, I guess, they made during the war because they were trying to save on aluminum, because that's what all this stuff is made out of. Got these utensils with it, but these are just these are Canadian military ones I just sort of put with it in 1952. But and it was almost identical to this, so I started looking up like Boy Scouts of America mess kit or something like that, and there was ones that look identical to this. This one's made in Korea, but then there was like, now you can buy knockoffs that are like a Coleman brand or something. Buy them at like Walmart or something like that. And they're basically the same, but they're a little bit flimsier, I guess, thinner metal and stuff. But anyway, this one comes in a little pouch, and it's seen better days. It's all, well, it was actually green one time. It's pretty faded now. So anyway, put that away. The strap's all, it's pretty rotten, but. Anyways, you got this little wing nut here. Holds the, it's part of the handle for the fry pan. Just loosen, you just loosen it a little bit, and you can. Yeah, I guess. Move that around. Take that back up. Take it. You get like a plate with it. Do a little measurements just so you get sort of a better idea of what you're looking at here. So it's about 7 inches across with the plate. Just measure the deep it is. Inch and 3/4 deep. This one's fairly thick metal into it. Some people are kind of against using aluminum to eat off of, but I guess if you use like a plastic utensil, you're not scraping the metal into your food. But anyways, you get a plate, you get a little pot here, and I guess the legit ones have a little, like a metal wire handle that's, as you look, it like lays flat and you stand it up. This one's got a little screwed on plastic handle, which I guess is a little bit different than the, I guess the new knockoffs have, like, it's riveted on, so if it's, if something goes wrong with it, you're kind of boogered. This one, at least, if it's, does something, you know, you ends up breaking off or melting off or something, you can put another one in. So you get a little pot, a little cup with it. And these are actually, you know, fairly substantial handle on it. I guess you can get a little pot stand, you can put it in the fire and boil water with this, or whatever. I think the handle's supposed to stay, it has little lines here, where I think it's supposed to sort of, like it sort of stays that way, but I think it's sort of supposed to snap up and stay, but it doesn't, so whatever. But a little drinking cup. And I think they had like a canteen that they, it was like a, they probably built like a clone to that too, but it was like a Boy Scouts canteen, I guess. And a fry pan, it's really thin metal, but, you know, it's usable. Of course, riveted on here, and everything says, well, you can see that one before you open it. It says Korea. I think it says Korea on it somewhere. That one. What says it on? Oh yeah, it says it there. Stamped on that, but it's kind of neat anyway. I've had it for years, I've never used it, but you can see it was well somebody was using it before I got it, so I can't remember what I paid for it. I don't think I paid very much, but a couple dollars probably. But I think the new ones are, they're like 15 bucks or something at Walmart. Well, it was in the States, but it's, yeah, kind of neat anyway. At least you have, you know, if you had to cook something or boil a little bit of water, you could, or a cup you can drink with, or at least you got a plate, so it's sort of usable, I guess. But just kind of neat anyway. I wasn't really sure what it was, and then when I found out what it was just wandering around YouTube watching videos, and this one does seem to be a little bit better than the new ones now, but it's not as good as the legitimate one that was made in the States. But and the steel one would probably even be better. It'd be heavier, but because this doesn't weigh a whole lot of anything, but it's just the, I don't know, some people just don't, well, I'm not, probably not a big fan of eating off aluminum either, but there is some health concerns, I guess, connected to it, but a lot of old people walking around that probably eat off this stuff, and they're still going, right? So, that's proof of anything. So, anyway, I just found that kind of neat. Maybe somebody that's in the States that was in the Boy Scouts has triggered some nostalgia or something. So, and I guess somebody should maybe point out, I think these holes here, so you can put a stick through the handle here, in case the handle gets hot when it's on the fire. I believe that's what it's for. I think most people mention that, but I, that's not what it's for. You can use it for that, I guess. So. But so. So anyway, thanks for watching, guys, and talk to you later.